Of the three phones in Nokia's US Lumia 920 lineup, T-Mobile's 925 is the best hardware hands down. Slimmer than the rest, it's also made with premium aluminum elements, and it has a tight fit and finish that approaches the pristine finesse of HTC's One. Nokia pumps up this feel by backing off the Lumia's screaming colors and muting the palette to white, black, and gray. T-Mobile has it in white. A few design quibbles chip away at the effect, like edges that seem sharp despite the phone's curved edges. Now, a competent camera with terrific low-light performance backs up the design of this global flagship, which is the same OS and apps as other Lumia 920 phones. Unfortunately for it, the 925's stay at the top is short-lived and already overshadowed by AT&T's forthcoming Lumia 1020 and its 41-megapixel camera. Still, T-Mobile customers should feel happy with this great-looking Windows 8 phone, which costs $49.99 down and $529.99 all in. Now, the design and build on this phone, while maybe not quite as good as some of the premium Android handsets available now, is nothing to sniff at, and it looks very good when using it. You're not going to have any objections with how this phone feels or looks when, you know, in real life. Its camera is pretty good, although admittedly not as good as the 1020's 41 megapixel camera. Call quality is alright, although in some US cities it tends to patch out a little bit. But that said, volume is loud and strong, and you know, my audio came over a little distorted perhaps, but it's not unpleasant. And background noise is definitely kept at bay, and I would give this phone at least a B+ for audio. Now, physically, Nokia Lumia 925 is a sleek, good-looking, tailored device that proves Nokia is adept at making phones with understated elegance, not just statement pieces. Indeed, Nokia has had a long history with the design, and that's coming out now. The fact that the 925 also backs up its hardware with Nokia's software, apps, and services goes a long way towards making this the top Windows phone for now. With the Lumia 1020 and its 41 megapixel camera looming, the 925 will look weaker in comparison, especially with only 16 gigabytes of storage for photos and videos. And there's also the question of Windows Phone as a platform. It's weaker in terms of capability than Android and iOS, and it doesn't have quite the same amount of top-tier apps. But although Microsoft has advanced on this tremendously. Also, Windows Phone 8 isn't as graphical to behold, but I would still say T-Mobile customers on the lookout for a Windows Phone device in particular, or a straightforward smartphone in general, should absolutely make the Lumia 925 their top choice. Those seeking a blow-you-away camera experience on Nokia's most advanced phone yet should hold out for the Lumia 1020. Thanks for watching this review, and I'll see you next time.